Hi, my name is Jason Chonko. I'm with Lakeshore Cryotronics, and in today's quick video, we're going to take a look at making low resistance measurements. All right, so let's take a look at what we have set up on the workbench. We've got our demo test fixture. So this is a 10 milliohm resistor. You may notice that it has four leads. And I'll explain those in a minute, but basically a 10 milliohm resistor in this nice test fixture. It's connected up to our M81, which is our source measure system from Lakeshore Cryotronics. In this case, we are going to be sourcing current. We're using the BCS10, which is our balanced current source. And that's going to be sourcing current through the device under test. And then we're going to be performing a voltage measurement using our VM10 or voltage measurement module. Well, to explain this in a little bit more detail, we're going to be making a four-wire measurement. In a four-wire measurement, we're typically sourcing current and then measuring voltage as closely as we can to the device under test. And we're primarily doing that in order to minimize the resistance, the loss due to the resistance of the leads. So if we had really long leads separating our current source from our device under test, and we were making the measurement back here in what's typically called a two-wire measurement, we were making our voltage measurement here at this end, we would have the voltage drop of all of that lead and contact resistance leading to the device under test in both directions. So that's going to add more error. This technique is called a four-wire or Kelvin measurement. And in that setup, we're sourcing current, but then we're making a remote voltage measurement on the device under test itself. And in that way, since there's very little current flow to the voltmeter, we're going to have a more accurate measurement of the resistance that we're testing. So the first thing that I would like to do is, after we've done the setup here, the first thing that I would like to do is take a look at sourcing 10 milliamps. So we just got 10 milliamps coming out of the current source through this resistor, and we're measuring 9.67 milliohms, which is pretty good. But I'm going to do something here. I'm just going to switch the polarity. So we're sourcing a positive 10 milliamps. Let's flip it back to a 10 milliamps. So in this case, again, we're making a DC measurement on this device. So now we're reading 10.3 milliohms. And remember, in the positive direction, we were reading 9.6. And so I'm just going to switch back to the positive direction. 9.6. So we do have a discrepancy in the positive and the negative direction when we're sourcing a DC current. And this is due to the offsets within the source and the measurement circuitry. And this is inherent to all instrumentation. Everything has all instruments have specifications on their offsets, or usually in the specifications documentation for the instrument. But when we're doing a DC measurement, those offsets can play a role in our error. And I'll illustrate this in a little bit more detail by dropping that current value. So instead of 10 milliamps, I'm going to lower it down to 1 milliamp. So I've just dropped it by a factor of 10. And now you'll see I'm reading 6.3 milliohms. When we know this is a 10 milliohm resistor, 6.3 is quite a bit of error. And then if we flip the polarity, now we'll see that we're reading 13.7. So now our error bars are getting bigger and bigger. And it makes sense, right? As we lower our current or our source signal, we're also going to lower the voltage measurement. And the offsets are fixed on every range. So as we get closer and closer to those offsets, they become a larger portion of our measurement. So we get larger error as we decrease the signal levels. One really convenient way of getting around this is to use a lock-in technique. With a lock-in technique, it does not have as much effect, or the offsets don't have as much of an effect on the actual measurement. And I can show you that really quickly. I'm just gonna go over to the M81, to the source. We're gonna change its shape to sine. A brief introduction to lock-in techniques. We're going to be sourcing a sine wave of a set frequency, and then we're going to filter the measurement circuitry such that only that frequency or very little frequencies around that input frequency or that reference frequency are going to be included. And that helps to minimize the noise. It also decreases the effect of offsets in our measurement. So I've set up my source as a 13.3 hertz sine wave at 1 milliamp. Just change the polarity, even though it really doesn't matter. I'm going to change my measurement from DC to lock-in, and I'm just going to change this over to resistance, and we're just going to give it a little bit of time to settle. With a lock-in measurement, it does take some time based on the time constants and the filtering to get to a settled measurement, but you can see now we're reading 10.04 milliohms. which is really an accurate reading for this particular device. And we're at 1 milliamp. So what happens if I drop it even further? Let's say I go to 100 microamps. So, and then we give it a little bit of settling time. And we're getting there. And so now we're at 10 milliohms again. So we've started with 10 milliamps where we had a fairly accurate measurement of that 10 milliohms, but we did have some offset because when we switched to negative polarity, we saw that change. And then we went to 1 milliamp and we saw even worse offset values. And so our measurement was even more uncertain or more error in it. Now we've dropped to 100 microamps. So we have 100 times less current coming in than we originally had on our 10 milliamps. And we're reading a very, very solid value. And we could actually go even further in current. It just takes longer to make the measurement. So the advantages of a lock-in technique for a low resistance, you can minimize the amount of power that you're delivering to the device under test. And that can be really critical if we're in a cryogenic environment. We're working very hard to keep the device under test very cold. We want to minimize how much current we're pumping into that device because it's going to radiate heat. The more current we put in, the more heat we're going to add to the system, and we're going to be fighting that. So we want to minimize that heat, as that self-heating as much as possible. We can do that by lowering the current. But as we've seen, if we lower the current, we are lowering our voltage measurement in that case, and that's also going to make the measurement more difficult. So again, a lock-in technique allows us to lower that source current, lower this measurement voltage, but we can still make an accurate reading. So I hope that you found this video to be helpful. If you have any further questions or would like to look up more information, please go to the Lakeshore website, www.lakeshore.com.